All right. Welcome back to another beautiful episode. As you can see, I got my man right here, Mr. Matthew.
Hey, guys.
He's going to give us another little fact for the day. You know, it's Black History Month, so drop the jewels, bud.
So there's this woman. Her name is Ruby Bridges. And okay. She was like the first black person to go to a only white school. Okay. And every parent there was super mad. Whenever she went to the school, she had to have security guards with her because they would, like, be mad, have signs like, get Ruby Bridges out of here or throw it to tomatoes. And they would have went, if they tried to do, like, offense to Ruby Bridges, they would have went to jail. So Ruby Bridges was, like, traumatized. I was like, she was like, oh, my gosh.
And what would you done if you're Ruby Bridges?
I was like, get out of here. This is my federal school. Federal property thing. Yeah, I don't know.
So what would you have done, though? Would you have gone to your classes or would you be like, I'm going to go homeschool?
I would be like, I don't care. I'll stay in this school. I'll learn and I'll do whatever I got to do.
And that's the message from my man, Matthew. Go to school. Don't care what anybody tells you. Welcome back, folks, to another beautiful episode. On today's episode, we're going to touch on a subject that we both found to be quite intriguing. Something
interesting.
I didn't even know this was actually a prevalent issue back home until my man brought it up to me. But skin bleaching, or as they call it, fairness cream.
Fairness. So one of the reasons why I even said let's talk about this issue was more or less because I seen a question that a young lady, I think she was like 17 years old, she Ethiopian, and her question was, what's the best skin
whitening cream?
Yeah, like on there. So I was like, you know, and I see a lot of like ads and things in that nature where it talks about fairness skin.
Yeah.
So for me, it was like, at some point, it was like, oh, that's whatever. They're just selling, you know, everybody's trying to do something, like, when it comes to skincare, because you see a lot of people putting everything in their house, like avocados and turmeric, and you name it. Everything is like face mask. You feel me? So when, everything. They put everything in their face as a mask. So I was like, you know what? What is fairness? Like, so when it comes down to it, I'm going to actually read you what fairness means. I didn't even know until I actually looked it up. And I was like, yo, like, this is crazy. Because one of the definitions for fairness is the quality of having light-colored hair or a pale complexion. So I was like, yo, that's not like, you know, when I'm seeing this.
Thing.
Yeah, when I'm seeing this advertisement going on, I'm like, yo, that's fairness doesn't even, you don't even want to go into that. When it come down to it. So when you're naming a cream, fairness cream or whatever, skincare, it's like, yo, like, we need to chill out on that. Especially right now, it's picking up within our community, within Ethiopia at least.
Oh, for sure, man. And I didn't think that people would get into the whole bleaching idea. My first taste of it actually came from, like, Vibes Cartel. I don't know if you listen to, like, reggae music, but he was an artist.
Oh, yeah. I seen
him.
And,
like, literally, when he first came out, my man was, Jamaica. Like, my complexion. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? This man's from the islands. Now, like, before he went to jail, my man looked like Sammy Sosa. Sammy Sosa himself.
He does it, yeah.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah, it's
like,
it's
Sammy Sosa
problem.
Was a dark-skinned brother. Now, if you look at him, my man looked like a ghost.
Yeah,
Casper.
No, definitely.
And it's crazy, man, especially when you think about it. Like, the idea of bleaching your skin, it's like, how you got to a point of, you know, you don't like yourself so much or
that
your
you
complexion.
Gotta change it. Yeah,
yeah, man. And it's crazy because when you think about it, it's like, why do we do this? And it's like the trauma that has been instilled in our community through colonization, yeah, through like media and how they portray
everything been whitewashed.
Oh, for sure.
Like, I mean, low key, if you even look at it in religious aspect, like, you know, the Last Supper, all white
dudes.
You know what I mean? Like Jesus,
no black friends.
He had blue eyes and blonde
hair.
Yeah, blonde hair. Like literally, Mary.
White women.
So, but then if you really dig down and then go into like all the temples where
back home that are predating any of our history,
exactly, and they're all like black with like days. Afro hairs and things in that nature. I mean, Lucy. If you really, they found her in Ethiopia.
Salam.
And she was, Salam actually predates her. Yeah.
You feel me?
When it comes down to it, like, why is everything whitewashed? You feel me? Like, why is everything?
I mean, what you think when you think about it is they control a lot of the mainstream media.
Everything.
A lot of the advertisement. Even if you think about it, like the top name brand companies that make these whitening creams are, you know, American or European, you know, staples like L'Oreal.
Yeah. Yeah.
What is the other one? Olay. Procter & Gamble. Johnson & Johnson.
We're talking about a $14 billion industry.
And to think,
you know what
like,
I mean? So,
and out of that $14 billion, a lot of it doesn't even come from Africa. That's the funny part.
It's in Asia,
which supports like $7.5 billion.
Mm-hmm.
India contributes for
more than $400 million worth of skin whitening products is sold each year in India alone.
8 out of 10 women in Nigeria use skin lightening products, the world's highest percentage.
Skin lightening market in Asia Pacific alone is valued at over $13 billion.
And then Africa contributes that
$2 billion. Yeah.
And it's wild.
But no, the thing is, it's already projected by 2027 is going to be over $47 billion. So they're already pushing that agenda.
So if you need your cream, holla at us down at the comments.
Like, nah. We ain't about to be doing none of that. Nah. We can't even.
Saying? Look,
yeah,
man,
nah,
let me just get like a. Let me just, you know what I'm saying, $1 billion.
Nah,
you know what I'm saying?
No. It's one of those things. It's actually a bigger problem than we think it is, especially right now. What was the numbers in Nigeria?
8 out of 10 women in Nigeria use skin lightening products, the world's highest percentage.
It was like 77% of the women have
used it
or have been in contact with some kind of cream.
Yeah.
So right now it's actually, they're pushing it throughout the whole Africa, low
key. They're pushing it heavy.
Yeah, and I seen some advertisement within the Ethiopian community, and I'm like, yo, what the hell is going on? Like, nobody's, like, peeping the game, or is it just...
Yet neshattulunyum, sralayni, lefitachin addis mefteyim ettol. Nisa Lovely Fairness Cream, yetelayu vitaminochun boustu yeyaze, hullun katafetro. Yetet arranna fikkit yalek odandinorot yadargal. Nisa Lovely Fairness Cream እስከ ወዲያኛው የጸዳ ነው የሚያበራ ፊት እንዲኖርዎት ያደርጋል. Nisa Lovely Fairness Cream መጠቀም ውበቶን ከእለት ወደ እለት እንዲጨምር ያደርጋል. Nisa Lovely Fairness.
It's crazy because it's one of those things where especially with the social media and
she knows she's
aspect.
Wrong. She definitely knows she's wrong cuz the comments on that joint is turned off. All her other posts you can comment
on,
but
okay,
that
cuz
she knows that, you know, people who
appreciate their skin color,
are
going
to comment and notify people
the
chemicals, the different effects that it has are so negative.
I mean,
that it's not
worth it. Let's actually talk about the negative aspects. What are some of the
so if you think about it, right, it's in order to get your skin tone to get fair or pale, as a black person, you have to eliminate the melanin. You
within
know what I'm
your,
saying?
Yeah.
Within your skin, or you have to block the melanin within your skin. So they use a lot of chemicals like mercury, lead, which, as y'all know, mercury poisoning, lead poisoning.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But these people will constantly apply it onto their body, so it blocks the light coming in
from the sun,
to the melanin, and then it just kind of slowly kills off that melanin. And what people don't understand is that doesn't make you look light skin. It actually deteriorates the complexion, so you actually turn out looking pinkish and not even like, you know what I'm saying, you're trying to go for that caramel, you out here looking like a pink starburst.
It's sad. Even like there's a lot of people like running away from the sun because of the complexion. It's literally like burning their skin. It's causing cancer. There's a lot of like
What was
matter of fact,
name?
On the article, it said there's two type of skin. Bro, there's ones that
don't work.
And then there's one that have a lot of side effects on them. Yes, so when it comes down to it, it's one of those things that it's not going to work. Oh, literally. Sure. It's like, it's just crazy.
And then that's the thing. Like you get skin cancer. And then like you were saying with the sunlight, it's photosensitivity. So like mm-hmm. when any type of UV light, so you can even
be in the sun. Yeah.
Not even like, the sun. Like I mean, UV lights from your studio, fluorescent lights and stuff like that. Bro, you're going to start burning. And it's going to feel like your skin is on fire, which... I've never felt that feeling before, but I assume it probably feels like when people get acid thrown on them or something of that nature. But
I mean, technically speaking, you are putting just acid on your body.
Oh yeah,
like low key.
Oh yeah.
And the crazy part is that a lot of people are spending a lot of money, like within the at least with the .com, like websites.
Yeah.
They were selling them from as low as like 500 birr to like 2,000 birr. Like I've seen some that was going for like 1,400 birr. So it's a lot of money when it comes down to it.
Yes, sir, bro. And I like, it's crazy to me, man. How we have so much pride in ourselves as
in our culture and everything,
But then you look at yourself and like, I could be two shades lighter.
You can't blame them because it's one of those things where everything been whitewashed. Like everything, like if
I
you
feel like it's a lack of information as well. Like
definitely.
Like in that article that you sent me, the guy who's talking about
who's bringing them from
and
Dubai.
He was like, you know, it's not my responsibility to inform people of the dangers. He's like, that's the government's responsibility.
He didn't lie because at least with Rwanda, people would do anything for money when it come down to it. But same time, it's also the government's responsibility to step in, and that's why I like Rwanda because they seen how the spike was going up, people doing this, and they were like, yo, cut this out, and then they just banned it. They won't let it through their ports and things in that nature.
I think it's also because they adhere to what the World Health Organization said about the chemicals that they use.
His concern is backed up by the World Health Organization, which banned the cream's active ingredients hydroquinone and mercury in 2001.
Hydroquinone and mercury.
You know what I'm saying? You gotta be in chemistry class to know which one. I swear, triangles and all.
You feel me? You gotta find it on the periodic table, like
hydroquinone and mercury. Hydroquinone and mercury.
No, I want to have an obvious to try to pronounce that.
No, it's a lot of chemical, bro.
Yeah,
like,
man.
When it comes down to it, it's
And
you
the World Health Organization banned these products because of those ingredients.
Mm-hmm.
But if you look at it, a lot of the ones that come into Ethiopia come through India, the Middle East, and they don't adhere to any of the regulations given to the World Health Organization.
I mean, no, don't get me wrong. The Ethiopian government is doing their best to control certain things. Yeah, but then when it come down to it, there's always going to be fraud and there's always going to be corruption going on. Like, especially with
the border, brother. How you going to protect all that?
So on the article we read, which we were going to put in a description below, it talked about how the within the Dredwa port, it used to, there's a lot of corruption within that, and a lot of those creams are coming through that.
Yep, and then it's a bunch of land that you can't really, you know what I'm saying, control.
Can't.
If I drive through the desert, brother, and you expecting people to come through the main road, good luck, barada.
But then it also comes down to, like, how do we fix this? You know what I mean? Like, with everything that is going on within the world, you know what I mean? Like, how...
I think education, clearly, we got to clearly hold these companies, definitely these companies accountable.
Yeah.
I think, what was it, Johnson & Johnson discontinued their products, but L'Oreal and Unilever, if you look at that, Unilever is one heck of a company.
Yeah.
One heck of a company.
It's a multi-billion dollar industry, and one that's bombarded people with images of white skin being more desirable. As the Black Lives Matter movement gained traction in calling out racism around the world, it also pressured top brands to rethink their products. France-based cosmetics brand L'Oreal is removing the words promoting whiter skin from its products, such as fair and light. The Fair and Lovely product line by the Indian branch of Unilever will now drop the word fair. Many of its adverts have in the past promoted whiter skin on Bollywood celebrities.
Not in a good way. But, oh, what, bro? Like you said, Nigeria, 77% yeah. of them use it. Unilever is one of their main suppliers.
Do any of these skin lightening products look familiar to you?
This one does. In India, it's a hit.
If you look at the history of Nigeria, Nigeria goes, yeah. was the Niger group who sold the land.
77% of women.
Bro, they sold Nigeria to Britain, changed their name to Unilever,
mm-hmm.
and now they supply Nigeria with skin bleaching cream.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Like, bro, that's systematic if I ever see
it. Also reinforce centuries-old ideas about race and hygiene. Check out these old soap ads.
This was part of this larger project, right, of presenting white civilization, European civilization, as superior. And here the association is that blackness is a form of uncleanliness that can be wiped away. But it's also, in many ways, simply a very blatantly racist act.
Yeah, definitely.
But back to, sorry, I got a little off track. But the point is, they got pressed by these African countries. Mm-hmm. And they're like, well, you know, there's 300 million people that use the product. So if we stop, they're going to go find another
company.
You know,
that's going to do it. Yeah,
not even another company, but they're going to look for unsafe alternatives. So we're not going to stop. L'Oreal yeah. just ignored the question. They just didn't even respond to them. They're like, we're going to do what we do because.
At the end of the day, money, of course, you know.
Yeah, but it's at the same time. But that's what I'm saying, where you got to hold these companies accountable. Because
yeah, no, they are though, very responsible for it.
Though there is that want for it, you got to have some social responsibility.
Yeah, even
as a
Nivea had a backlash about it.
Oh, yeah.
I think it was in Congo or one of the countries where they were talking about fairness skin.
Yeah, and they were took like, out the fairness.
Yeah.
In it. Like, bro, like, forget the fairness. Take out the whole thing, brother. Stop promoting people to bleach themselves.
Yeah, no, like, it's definitely one of those things.
Education.
Personally speaking, I think we have to hold responsible people that are also dealing this, like making it cool, popular, yeah. or whatnot. You feel me? Like, it's one of those things where at this age and time where social media has become
so influential,
but like to the point where, you know, people are willing to do whatever it takes type of thing.
Oh,
and
bro.
You know, like with these filters and makeups and things like that, it's like, I'm like,
that's
yo,
a
like
whole
just,
nother episode.
Yeah, no, we're going to have to wheel it back, but yeah, definitely it's one of those things. But it's also, again, with the government, they have to kind of come in and say, yo, we do see what's going on and we're going to have to stop it. And I applaud.
Rwanda,
I think there was Rwanda Ivory
Ghana,
Coast.
Ivory Coast, South Africa, all banned.
Yeah.
Bleaching cream.
So I actually applaud them for that. And I think within our community, Ethiopia need to ban them too. I know within what I read, at least personally, they haven't banned any of them.
Not at all. They're not even considered.
It's
like
a matter of,
yeah,
it's in the back burner. At the same time, it's actually growing right now.
Popularity.
It's growing up where people are actually asking for more products to be out there,
yeah.
which is.
And I think, like you said, like you were talking about the 17-year-old girl, when she was asking about where can I find the best bleaching product,
mm-hmm.
we also as a community have the moral obligation.
But there were some
the
people
thing.
That
that's,
actually
that's
also gave her
the real deal spill about
they
it.
They were
like
where you can
is,
get this one and that one. So even when I did the research, I went in a couple of Ethiopian websites and they had like whitening sunscreen. I was like, what? How are you mixing those two up together? Like, what? Like, yeah. And then there's also other fairness creams or whatnot that
brands.
They have like lists of them.
Oh, yeah.
I'm talking about like you have so many options.
Yeah,
like
man.
One of them actually said, bleach my butt or something like that. I swear. Look it up.
But
and, but the crazy part is like that one was actually either disconnected or it was like sold out. on the website.
Hey,
and I'm like,
if you're
yo,
out here
that's crazy.
Your butt, I'm gonna need you to go ahead and figure your life
yeah.
out, bro.
So but when it come down to it, as you know, at least within the Ethiopian community, you know, like we need to hip our people.
Oh, for sure.
You know,
I mean,
like share those images of the churches where they actually have the black angels on the walls, the black Mary on the walls, black Jesus on the wall. Cause at the end of the day, representation is gonna matter when you're looking at an image and you look at yourself
and you don't see it in those positive lights. It's gonna
yeah get and then like when I was like what I came to America when I was 11, bro. And I remember
five.
When I was like 9 or 10 before coming here, there was some German people that came through our neighbor with a motorcycle, and I swear to God, I'm not even lying. We were chasing them just to touch.
Take me with you.
Literally, we were like literally trying to touch them. Like, hey, can you give me a high five? You know, like, because
go
we
back
seen.
To school and be like, I touched the white man yesterday.
Literally, the standard we have for white people was like up there, bro. Like, yeah. It's crazy to the point where we're looking at them like.
And that's
you
the
know.
Thing, bro. Like, I think, like you were saying earlier, before we were shooting. It's a lot of the representation that you get associated with black people.
Bruh, so let me tell you a funny story. Let me tell you a funny story right here. So, you know, I'm a Howard. I was working in an alumni association, right? So we were having a
drumline?
No, like we we were having a it was like they celebrate their 50th anniversary every time. Yeah. So I got to meet so many educated and like well off
black folks
that would be like so funny. Like, and so we were having a conversation, you know, like telling him I'm from Ethiopia, you know, I'm always like, you know, Ethiopia.
Judah.
Yeah. So the guy was like, yo, you know what's crazy? He's like, why is everything when it's black is always represented it like negative? And at this time we were actually eating cake dessert time, right? So he was like, so they pretty much we were eating the chocolate. So this is called the devil's cake because it's chocolate, right? And I'm like, damn, bro. Okay. And then he's like, so why do they
call that joint angel food?
Angel food. And then there's actually the white cake. So it's like, usually when it comes down to it, the
black air forces.
Bro, like, tell me about it. That's like the gangster who's going to shoot up the place.
But if you got the white joints,
you
fresh.
Yeah, like you clean.
I mean, even in movies, bro, like, a lot of times you notice that, you know, the villains or the thugs are the dark skinned dudes, and the humble, nice guys are the light skinned brothers. And I think it goes back, even in the American aspect, I feel like it goes back
to the slavery days. Yeah.
They had the light skinned brothers and sisters inside. Because they didn't want them to get sunburned. Because
master was the dad or whatever. Yep.
And then also, like, for marriage and stuff like that, it was more favored to have the light-skinned ones than having them out there working.
And it's been going on even with social media. I don't know. You've seen the challenges and all of that. They're all light-skinned, dark-skinned. It's always being divided.
Yep.
And then at the end of the day, they always put the dark skins as, like...
the ugly.
So. Yeah, like the... And it's, like, one of those things, but we need to change that.
And there was, I don't know.
The black cat, for instance, the black cat is considered as a bad luck. You know what I mean? Like,
I don't know, Jane Elliott, I don't know if you know the sociologist lady. She did a test with a bunch of kids.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I've seen
it,
yeah.
She gave them the dolls, and she gave them the black dolls versus the white dolls. And all of them threw away the black dolls because they were like, she dirty, she ugly, this, that, and the third. And all of them wanted, even the black kids were perpetuating the black. And it was just kind of like, to see the actual, like, level.
Where did we go wrong in Milo Party Marathon, you know?
And I feel like, you know, like you said, it's a lot of the social media aspect, I think, in our generation, at least, plays a big part in it.
It's also like the media, I mean, you name it.
Even music, bro, if you think about it, until recently, when they had...
They glorify light-skinned women
a lot. They had the
light-skinned
girls dancing. Mm-hmm. They would
all
really
the
have
the football
black
players
girls.
And basketball players, when they become successful, they usually marry
what
a white
Kanye
woman.
Say? When he get on, he leave you for a white girl.
And they gon' keep calling and trying, but you stay right, girl. And when he get on, he leave you for a white girl. Get down, girl. Go ahead, get down.
Which he did. I mean, he...
She Middle Eastern. But nah,
all right, we'll pass.
He definitely did.
But at the end of the day, I'm just saying, like, we need to
figure a way to kind of resolve the issues. And I feel like,
because it's bro, it's deep rooted to the point where, again, like,
bro,
if you got the angels are white, Jesus is white,
but all the demons look like us.
Yeah. So when you like looking at it that way, it's like, bro,
you're
like, where are we gonna be represented? You know what I mean? Like, at the end of the day,
it's a demon.
But when low key, it's the other way around, where, you know,
Jesus was really
black. Yeah, I'm gonna say it. You know, I mean, I'm gonna fight it. But
look at the text.
Yeah, no, it says it. He had skin like bronze, or his hair were like white as wool, and his reds were eyes.
You feel me?
Yeah. So,
and
so when you look at wool, with his hair were like wool.
It's nappy.
Yeah.
It's
so
a nice way of saying nappy.
So when it come down to it, at the end of the day, I feel like I've been just there's a few people within, you know, I guess low key that control the
mainstream media
aspect of like how we look at things, how we look at words. Of beauty. Yeah, even with the words you were telling me with the syllabus they use for black was
grimy, stuff like that. And this is like, that's wild. But then we look at it for like white,
it's like the angels and
you feel me. It's all this positive, lovey dovey stuff, and it's like, bruh.
Again, it goes back to the respect on devil's cake and then the angel's cake. Bro, like that just by itself.
You think about
why is the devil cake chocolate and then the angel's cake is white?
Bruh, the dove, the sign of peace and love, is a white bird.
Yeah.
I'm saying, why can't you just pick a pigeon? I'm saying, why not a falcon?
What do you call when somebody's like trying to extort you for money?
Blackmail.
Yeah. When do you go to
a lot of game right
now? When do you go to get like cheapest deals in the world?
Black Friday, bruh. Do you?
I mean, I like Black Friday, but at the end of the day, it comes down to like, why are everything that are associated with cheap demonized or everything in the sense of negative? It's considered tukur. Like, and I'm like, yo, like that aspect, we need to change that. When it's actually the other way around. If you really look at it, even history would tell you, like, you know what I mean? It's
and that's the thing, bro. Like you said, I think it's important that, you know, in order to change the view,
the narrative, like we have to intermine.
It has to be from us. It has to be from our government. It has to be from the social media aspect, and it has to be. When I say us, it means us holding all these brands accountable. Like we did the last episode, we were talking about how we spend as minorities or as black folk, we have the highest buying power. We spend the most with these companies. When you go to Balenciaga and you see them with the little monkey t-shirts and stuff like that, but you still buy it. When you go, even right now, Louis Vuitton put out the Ethiopian flag shirt, but called it the Jamaican cultural.
I'm gonna fight you on that.
Bruh.
Like the reason why they do that is marketing. It's marketing. I'm telling you, it's marketing.
When they actually like wrote, they're like the black, green.
Bro, I'm telling you. Yeah, no. Like I understand that, but at the same time, usually these companies. Yeah, that's what they're doing. These companies will have.
You're smacking me in the face right
now. Yeah, exactly. That's the whole point. That's the whole point. But then at the same time, you shouldn't been investing in Louis Vuitton or even give them the time of your time of your day, because at the end of the day you should be investing within your own people. But got you. But what I'm saying is, when it comes down to it, when these companies do things like that, they do it on purpose so that they got people like us talking about them right now. So we just gave them a free advertising, you feel me, low key. Because when it come down to it, they even with Gucci, you think when they put the monkey face,
the black face joint,
yeah. So you think they didn't know what was going on?
Find some. Go back to FUBU, man.
No,
go buy some FUBU, guys.
I agree with you. Some Sean John. When it come down to it, they do it on purpose. They do it on purpose because people are going to talk about it. Guess what happens after like 3-4 months? You forget about it.
Oh, for sure. They're going to go buy it on clearance on Black Friday.
Technically, yeah. So
you know what I'm saying?
When it come down to it, it's for me, that was a low-key genius advertising.
No, I mean, again,
people gonna get wild up. They're gonna post it for free, and then brand recognition, and then they're gonna say, "Oh, we are sorry."
Do you think they do it on purpose?
I'm 100% they do it on purpose, bro.
Like they just
because
like,
it's free advertising.
Put that monkey on that black man's face. Let's see what happens.
Yeah, and then people gonna get outraged about it. Woo woo, and then their stock market might go down for a week, and then that's it. Guess, but
like they say, at the end of the day, all publicity is good publicity, better.
In America, at least
Africa, they come and chop your head off.
When it come down to it, low key, what we are trying to highlight today on this episode is more or less like, be proud of your skin color. There's no need for you to put chemicals in your skin that can cause
cancer,
death, and
irreparable damages to your skin.
Yeah, be proud of who you are, where you came from. Don't affiliate your skin color with
success.
Yeah, none of that.
You know, a lot of people do. They think
they do.
You know,
so
being white is equivalent to being wealthy, being rich, vice versa.
So it is one of those things where we need to, at least within the Ethiopian community right now, like we said, it's just becoming surface level known, but there's a lot of people using this stuff. Just want to highlight that the fact that you don't need this stuff. Be careful using this stuff. don't even use it at all.
Vaseline! የተጣራና ፍክት ያለ ቆዳ እንዲኖርት የሚያርግ ቫዝሊን እስከ ወዳኛው እስከ ወዳኛው ድረስ አሪፉ በት እንዲኖርት ያርግ
ለሞክረው
ካላት ወደ እለት አሪፍ እንዲሆን ፊታችሁን አሪፍ ቢዩቲ እንዲሰጣችሁ ያርግ
እንደዚህ ነው
በቃ ታበዛለች ከዚህ ምን አነቱ ነው በእናታችሁ ፈስ
ላይክ cuz
I'm black and I'm proud bro
you know it So
Just keep it that way. Happy Black History Month, folks.
We out. Take care of yourself.
Don't forget, like, subscribe. This is a new channel. So, you know what I'm saying?
Subscribe to the channel.
We need them numbers up, man. Come on. please.
Pretty, please.
We're going to make my accent come out.
yeah. But we got
It's like, nah. But yeah, man. Like, yeah. Subscribe, comment. Let us know how you feel about this. Let us know if you used this cream before, if you haven't, you know, so on and so forth. And then let us know what you guys want to hear for the next episode. Real quick, what are you thankful for?
Oh, man, you about to make this journey. Quick. All right, well, I'm always thankful for Bulletin everything, points. Bro. But thankful for the fam, for everything that's going on. Everything is busy, but at least, you know, we're keeping up. But thankful for everything that's going on, bro. I can't even pinpoint one thing right now.
That's all gravy, you know what I'm saying? That's why I said bulletin. You know what I'm saying? We don't need full sentences. Yeah. I'm thankful for my parents' health, my family's health, you know what I'm saying? My brother's health. I'm thankful for my puppies. I'm thankful. Oh, they're getting big, bro. They're going to be here in like an episode or two. Y'all going to love them. I'll be thankful when Caleb cleans this fish tank. God, Lee.
You better take care of that.
We'll figure it out. But you know what I'm saying? I'm thankful for y'all. So we love y'all. Like, comment, subscribe. Let us know what y'all think, what y'all want to see. Follow us on social media.
I'd have to know.
That's when you did. Thank you.